I'm very excited and very honored and blessed to welcome the beautiful Master Hock Yo. I hope I pronounced that
Thank you.
correctly. It's so wonderful to see you here today. Hock and I have known each other for a while now and been in touch, and I've greatly admired the work that you're doing for the planet. And Master Hock is, I'll read a bit of, about his bio so you've got an understanding of what he is doing. Is extraordinary in the field of metaphysics. He has vast knowledge in the fields of feng shui, energy healing, and esoterics. In feng shui, he was trained by several masters, mainly from Hong Kong, and has helped many in overcoming their life's challenges. He specializes in medical and business feng shui. Grandmaster Yap personally tutored him. He is among the few who uses the very difficult I Ching divination calculations, where few feng shui masters dare to venture. In energy healing, he is trained in both Reiki and blue energy healing. I'm a Reiki master too. We've got
Nice.
that. Lovely. He is also a medical intuitive and interprets auras. He has been guided by his spirit and angel guides in his work. Anyone who engages Master Hock Yao can expect a very high level of dedication, expertise, and truth in his work. So it's really wonderful to welcome you today at this crucial juncture in the history of our entire planet. So great time to talk with you. And how are you personally going, Hock?
Oh, thank you very much for that lovely introduction. So I'm feeling great. And I've made several recent discoveries about myself.
Yes, I think we all have. Yes. Yes.
That's right.
Yeah.
So it's a real great pleasure to be talking to you, Madini. So I was looking forward to this meeting because I think we will be going through a lot of topics today, and then which will be very informative to many people.
Yes, absolutely. Especially as there's so much being censored now, and there's that inability in many platforms to get the word out about what is really happening in truth, you know, what is happening. So it's an honor to have you here. And I think that's a fantastic point you've started the whole interview with, Hock, is that you can view this whole transition that we're going through on an earthly level as a challenge or a difficulty, but you can also view it as the greatest spiritual test that we could possibly have. It's an opportunity for self-mastery. It's the greatest opportunity for self-mastery. And I think people need to remember that. I remember personally when I had a baby who passed at birth, it was the greatest spiritual learning and opportunity for me. And I went through this dark tunnel. But I tell you, it's given me the gifts and the skills and the abilities to be here now at this time and to stand strong as much as I can. And we all have our ups and downs, but to stand strong as much as I can in this crucial moment where we're holding the energy for a lot of people, especially if we're able to maintain a high frequency. So I think that's a great point. So I'd like to start with the question, how are you viewing the overall energy of the world at the moment, the overall energy of the planet? Are you getting a sense of how we're going in terms of this spiritual war on consciousness that we're facing, where it is light against dark, good against evil in a sense? How's the energy feeling for you overall on the planet?
Well, Madeni, what I'm feeling is that the light, although is winning in many fronts, but the dark side is putting up very heavy resistance.
Mm.
And we may expect it to be an even tougher times ahead, but not to fear, because after that period, things will go a lot faster and better. You may notice now that sort of time is speeding up. It's already October. And 1 week will go by very fast. This is because everything has been speeded up. And Mother Earth Gaia actually cannot wait much longer. Yes. So she's hoping that more and more people are awakened. And indeed, there are so many reports from other light workers about more and more people are waking up.
True. Yeah.
So in summary, do not fear, but look forward to better times ahead.
Yes.
And the energy for October, from what I get, is it's time to act. Because what the benevolent beings from the other universes, they can do a lot of to help via energy wise, but we humans have to act.
Definitely. I think it is our free will, that choice that we need to enact now. And it's, when you look at it collectively, we need everyone to act, but also individually, your soul is being asked to stand up on a spiritual, on a soul level, which is the main reason why we are here. And so yeah, you are being asked to overcome your fear and stand in your truth and stand up for what you believe in the midst of everything that's going on. The fear-based paradigm where we just comply to things that we don't agree with is over now. And your soul is being asked to step into its empowerment. And this ultimately is your test, nobody else's.
Exactly. Well said.
Well, you bring it out in me, Hawk. Lovely. So in terms of planetary focuses at the moment, Australia and me being in Australia is quite a focus, because there is so much nefarious, dark activity going on, particularly when you look at the police in Melbourne and Victoria, and some of them are not even looking like police. They look like foreign troops or UN troops, or in their black regalia. And they're so incredibly, non-human. It's like they're soulless. Yeah. There's no heart. There's no compassion. We implore and appeal to any police that are watching to tap into your heart and tap into your humanity, because we're seeing a complete lack of that in a lot of this behavior. And in Sydney, you know, we see it a lot around Australia at the minute, and the forced things for, you know, original communities and things like this. It's very extremely nefarious. You know, many of us have heard what's going on here and how it looks like a fascist, you know, dictatorship at this point. So what are you seeing playing out here in Australia, and how can we, perhaps for people that are watching, energetically contribute to shift this current paradigm? Because I do feel like we are a key birthing place for what's happening on the planet. And so what happens here is intended by the negatively polarized ones to impact the rest of the world after it's impacted here. So if we cut it off here, cut off the head of the snake, as they say here, then that will impact the world. So what can you say to that, Hock?
Exactly, because all eyes are looking at Australia now.
Yes.
And the actions taken by your truckers, we have noted it, all right? So that's why I say in this month of October, the message is action. And the action done by the citizens of Australia will be multiplied the world over.
Yes.
All right. So the point is every person in the world, and especially in Australia, they must send a message from their minds to the universe. And the message is this, that you can overcome any obstacles put up by the darkness. Because this is what we call like the 100th monkey effect.
Yes.
All right. So once you put that message out, even one person into the universe saying that Australia will overcome the draconian implementation of laws on its citizens, all right, will be overcome. And once you a person and once an Australian or anyone in any part of the world have that in mind and put it out to the universe, the collective thinking will boost up the positive energy. So please, no excuses. Oh, I'm just one person. I'm a nobody, you know. So get it out of your thinking. Even if you spend 1 minute saying that we Australians can do it.
Yes,
all right.
Definitely we can. And for everyone watching, please just spend 1 minute now, just pause the video and just say, Australia has overcome all nefarious activity, all darkness, all agendas. That would be brilliant. Thank you everyone out there for contributing to that. That's really special. And I wanted to say too that there's just a mandate that's come to the whole of Victoria now, the southern state, where every single worker has to have one of these. So this was 2 days ago. So everyone is no longer able to just sit on the fence any longer because it's just been mandated. They have to take action and just, you know, dig deep into your inner core, your foundational strength, and do what you can in whatever way you can to step out of this system. And that was my other point I was going to make too, Hock, was that when these sorts of measures come in and people don't agree with them and they're exiting the system because they don't want to comply, it's actually an incredible opportunity to create a new system. That's what it's about. It's not trying to hold up an old system that no longer functions and is completely out of sync with humanity and who we are now. It's really about when you are being told to do something that doesn't align with your truth, it's now an opportunity to step into a whole new paradigm, and you are the one that has to create it. You are the one that has to step out into new territory and create what hasn't existed. And this is why this is happening. It's not about trying to hold up an old system and finding ways that you can get rounded or whatever. It is creating a new system and consciously stepping out and saying, I do not, as a free will, I am presence. I do not support this system that no longer aligns with my soul and my truth.
Exactly, because once you put out that word, I do not consent to this being forced, all right? We do not consent. You're sending out that energy. Okay, right?
Yeah.
It's very fundamental. Everything is energy, and you need to show the world that you do not consent to these draconian ways of governing anywhere.
Because they're upstairs, you know, that they want to support the free will of humanity. So they're constantly assessing or analyzing what we want and where we're at. So we need to make a really clear, and I encourage everyone to do it regularly, a really clear intention out there that this is our truth. You know, you can write it down, you can say it out loud, you can put it through your meditations, but just to make sure that you're getting your message out to the universe really, really clearly. That's a fantastic point, Hock.
Exactly, because what I wanted to say is that you mentioned some of the police or whatever organization there, many are non-humans. Can you give me a minute while I make some contact and tell you about these non-humans?
That would be wonderful. I'm wondering if there are clones or you
yeah,
know.
Yeah, yeah, just hang on. Just
Thank
hang
you.
On. Yeah, you're right. They are non-humans. Now I'm going to start try to find out the percentage in the police. Okay, that explains. It's about 24% of your police force are non-humans. And that is why these 24% are heartless.
Yes.
They would push down an old woman.
Yes.
Who is defenseless on the floor and kick her, you know.
And
no humans would really do that.
No, and pepper spray a young child who's holding a sign saying, "Let me play." You know,
right.
Traumatizing
right.
The child. It's probably the black militia, the ones in the black, not so much the that way.
And the other thing is, if you are not going to put a stop to all these draconian laws, they're going to bring up another and then another and push people to the brink to separate out the sheep who's going to obey them, all right?
Yeah.
And those who are brave enough, all right? So it is time for action this October. It's time to put a stop. You cannot be a fence sitter anymore.
No, right? No.
Because they wanted two doses of this, and then it's going to be another third one of these.
Oh,
and then it's going
forever.
To be another,
yes.
Another, yeah.
On and on and on.
Shifting the goalposts, all right?
Yeah.
So until if you have no action right now for whatever draconian laws being implemented, later on it could be too late.
Exactly. And can I ask you, just going back to that previous thing we were talking about, is it an AI energy? Is it a clone? What do you see it as?
I get a very strong AI influence. And those in the forces, non-humans, they are not clones. That's as far as I could get.
So how do you deal with those energies because you can't relate to them on any sort of human level. You stay away from them.
You got to treat them as a collective, and in your actions against the draconian forces, you got to act as a group and do what you believe.
Yeah.
All right. And then I actually haven't looked deeply into that.
Yeah.
So it's not easy, but you got to do the first step. All right.
Well, I think when I see overseas, you know, if someone is being attacked, then often I've seen in like Germany and different countries, the group will gather around and they'll come in and they'll protect that individual. And I think we have to unify in that way and act in that way where we're collectively looking after one another. And it's just,
oh, yes.
It's not the person going in there and you know, just by themselves. So I think, you know, unifying in all these sort of ways is really important. Yeah.
Yeah. So that's why when you take action, you should be in a group and do not get separated.
Mm. Yeah.
Always in a group. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
So help is nearby.
Mm. True. Okay. So do you feel that we're making headway in Australia? I mean, I know there is this awakening happening. Do you feel that we're making progress there? How's it looking to you in a sort of like an overview?
Okay, hang on.
Thank you.
Okay. First of all, sometimes I get mixed up with the timeline in the sense that it may be very far in the future, it may be just around the corner, but the percentage of headway in Australia right now that I've just got the message is surprisingly, it's 78%.
Wow, good.
Yeah, so whether this is going to be a year from now, 6 months from now, I'm not too sure because it's muddled up.
Sure.
But the positive answer is so encouraging, Madini.
Oh, yes, definitely. That's fantastic.
It's very encouraging. In fact, I was surprised. I thought it was around 30%, you know.
Oh, what a relief. Oh,
but
yeah,
because when I start getting the answers, and I said, wow, it's so much.
Yes. Well, I think what's happening is they're amped, that they're desperate on you know, the nefarious ones. They're getting desperate, so they're amping everything up. So on the 3D level, it looks like it's getting worse in some ways, but that they're only amping all that up because they can feel this push of resistance that's happening, and they're trying to counter that.
Yeah, it is their news censorship.
Yeah.
That is why people in Canberra, people in Sydney may not get the real picture, all right, because of news censorship.
Yes.
So it makes, it looks as though that all you people, activists, whatever you are doing is not effective, but it is really effective.
Fantastic.
We have just found out.
Fantastic.
I think this is great. Great news.
Yes, the masses are really coming together. And, you know, we had a gathering up here just called Reclaim the Line the other day, and everyone was dressed in white. And there was like about 500 people all walking together, and it was a beautiful protest. And you know what was so gorgeous, Hock, was there's footage, and I might even add it in here. I'm not sure if it'll get censored or not, so I'm not sure whether to put it in, but there was footage of this woman hugging a policeman and him hugging her, and, you know, then everyone started hugging the police that were there, and it was beautiful. And if I can put it in here, I will, and that's what we need to see more of.
Yeah, mate, you're with us. I know you are. Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, while you were talking, and I've just confirmed, I saw the armed forces, that means the police, the riot squads, and so on, putting their arms down.
Fantastic. That's what needs to happen.
Yeah.
That they are with us. The majority of them are with us. It's only this smaller and the section that are not even human under this agenda that are doing the opposite of what the collective want. I mean, these people, the majority of police and armed forces, they've got family, they've got loved ones, they're part of the community. We're all connected, we're all one, and they should be able to feel that and see that. You know, we're not going against one another. And we can see that the government is completely tyrannical with all their mandates that aren't even lawful and all their regulations. So they should be able to see that. I mean, even many of them are being forced to have this when they don't want to as well, up in Queensland and everything. So, you know, I call on all of them to just do what they can to help us all collectively shift this together. Everyone wants to do this peacefully and I mean, you know, in a way that is has minimal damage to any human being. Is there anything that you would like to share under the very strong constraints that we have currently, talking in code and so forth, about that?
Well, the latest news I got is that actually the campaign for this, it would have resulted in even more severe complications had not the positive galactic forces intervened to neutralize many of these medication.
Oh, that's wonderful.
It would have been devastating.
Yes. Yes. So all how right. much has been actually neutralized by them in terms of, can you say a percentage or how much have they been able to?
Okay. Improve? Let me try to get some answers. Hang on.
Sure. Thank you.
Okay. Worldwide, they have succeeded in neutralizing about 11% of these vials of the mRNA, 11% so far.
Okay.
And I had on my part, when people contacted me that they are going for this, I've done my part.
So you worked with them afterwards, is what you're saying? Yes. Oh, fantastic. Yeah. Yes. Yeah, because we are all concerned about what will happen in the future, 6 months, you know, 1 year, 2 years.
I understand. Yeah.
Yes. Yes. And we all have loved ones who have been involved in this. And we're all praying that they will be.
And one tip, I just got a message. One tip is this. If a person, let's say, being forced for all these things, and he's on his way or being held down and done this, sometimes they do that.
Yes.
All the person has to say out loud is, I do not consent, because this gives a signal and the permission for the galactics to intervene and neutralize.
That's a powerful point. Powerful point.
I just got it, Madine. I just got it just now. That's the message I got.
Well, what comes to mind here is the original communities in Australia, where they're saying that the forces are going in and they're forcing this to them. So, and you know, trying to negate the pure DNA ancestral bloodlines of the beautiful brothers and sisters who are our original family here in Australia. They're trying to, you know, impact that. So, a call out to all original communities with this really important information. Thank you. Yeah.
Yes, please convey to them and everybody else who's listening here. If under such circumstances, where the person has absolutely no choice, just say out during a few minutes before they do this.
Yes.
I do not consent and try to look up in the skies.
Yes. Perfect. Perfect.
I will try to inform this to my galactic friends. Anybody who says that, they will zoom in and try to neutralize it. Yeah.
Perfect. Perfect. And a big shout out to and blessing to our galactic family for everything you're doing for us at this time as well. And also, please, you know, anyone who's watching, please share this video too to get the information out as well. Thank you. So we have some information here that you're wanting to share. Hock, is it a good time to share that? Okay. So I'm going to share this screen here.
Yeah.
And because we can't say these things, we thought we would make the interview quicker by just posting the information so people can scroll through and have a look.
Yeah, it's a, carry on, Madini, while I just keep on talking. This is a very quick summary, like a world news, and many people do not have the time to scroll for such news. And anyway, such news cannot be found in the mainstream. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to read the headlines and no details will be discussed. Just to give an overview of what has been happening. So first on the list is reported that a 16-year-old who suffered a heart attack after taking that received Singapore dollars 225,000 settlement from the Singapore government. And this is huge because many governments do not want to take such responsibility. So that came from Singapore. And then the next news is pharma-controlled media begins pushing the idea of another variant. And then so it goes on and on and on and on. If you do not stop, when will it stop?
And isn't it interesting now, the wording that they're using for these variants, because the MU is relating to me, Lemuria, you know, that old Lemurian energy, that's what it used to be called. So there, and these different names like the DELTA and things like this, it's interesting the wording that they're using because it's a subconscious programming as well, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Then the wonder drug is now the target of many, many smear campaigns.
Mm.
All right.
Yeah.
So ask yourself why. Why is this so? You know, that sets your mind thinking.
Mm.
And then this airlines is to impose monthly surcharge on their people who do not get that. On their employees. So they're putting up the pressure everywhere, organizations, countries, and so on. Then
can I add in there, Hock, that I think one of the reasons they're putting in the pressure is as time rolls on, we're hearing more and more about the things that are happening relating to that. So as we hear more and more, you know, through family and friends and community of adverse things happening, we are becoming more and more awakened to what's really in these things. So I think that's why they're trying to rush it as well.
Yeah, yeah. And this one, the next headlines is pretty disturbing because there are reports coming out now of fetal death after breastfeeding babies, all right? Taking milk from their mothers who had this.
Yeah.
This is very disturbing, honestly, because many pregnant ladies during pregnancy are being coerced to take this as
they
well.
Are. And I have a personal example of that in my family as well, very sadly.
So now they're pushing for kids under 18.
Mm-hmm.
So there, as you can see, these headlines pretty show a lot about that. There is never an ending to this campaign if you don't put a stop to it.
That's right.
Scroll a little bit down, Nadine.
Sure.
Okay, this is funny. It seems that there was a local TV station in the US who asked for stories of those people not getting that and dying from this so-called COVID. They got 180,000 people saying that after they get this, they were injured.
Oh, wow. Well, that's what needs to happen, doesn't it? Yeah. Wow.
So it backfired. It backfired that TV station's campaign.
Well, I remember here there was a journalist asking for information about what you've just said. So if we could all do that here, that'd be great. And it's interesting, isn't it? Because when the dark try and implement something or do something, what often happens is the inverse reaction happens, and then the light have an opportunity to come in and succeed. And I noticed that happening over and over again, both personally in my life and also in a collective level.
Yeah, and this one is coming from some, it's not from the mainstream news. And I tell you, it's like a little proof that we have of what's really happening in the grounds.
Exactly. Yes, perfect.
So the next headline is also very, scroll a little bit up, Nadine.
Oh, sorry,
Washington. This is very, very bad because they are hiring strike teams for such quarantine camps.
Mm.
And then they changed the wording to more conducive wording to get employers to be actually a strike team. And a strike team means it's just like the special forces. Mm. They come barging in, you know, and taking the people off to those FEMA camps.
Yeah.
So that's very recent news from Washington. Yeah, you can scroll down now.
Okay. Is that where you're wanting to go?
Yeah.
Great.
This is just like this headlines here on Michael Jacko interview is also the same like the above headlines about those FEMA camps. And then the positive news is about at that point in time, on the 27th of September, 4,600 doctors and scientists have signed declaration accusing that policymakers of crimes against humanity. So there are many moves being made, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes.
You are not alone. You may not get this news, and that is why I put it up. These are positive news, okay?
There's also a very big court case in South Africa happening, and they're saying it's the biggest one on the planet, which is huge against the whole pandemic narrative.
Yeah.
So that's also very exciting because that's huge. Yeah.
Yeah. So there are a lot of people now in the next headlines of people saying no. They include the Navy SEALs. A lot of them had resigned. They included a lot of US Air Force pilots.
Yeah.
and a lot of troops, service members, healthcare workers, nurses, drivers and truckers, airline pilots, troopers, school district employees, and also the issue of the illegal immigrants in the U.S.
Can I give you story, Hock, of this, a positive story relating to this? There was hospitals here, health workers were required to do this in Queensland, and they told their healthcare workers that it was, you know, mandatory. And there was this particular one that said, no way, he wasn't going to do it. And he stepped out of the system. He said, I'm going to leave this job. So he stepped out. 2 days later, they contacted him and they said that he could come back to work, sign an exemption form and come back to work, because they were so short of staff that they desperately needed people. And so they got him to come in, and so he didn't have to. And then there was other staff that had done it that were really put out and upset, because he just held off a bit and then was able to come back without complying. So I think that's a message for everyone out there.
Oh, yeah. And I didn't put it up here, but I got news that some hospitals in New York State, the obstetricians and the nursing staff, many of them had resigned, and they had to close down the obstetric labor room and wards. You see? So these are not reported in the mainstream, people.
No.
Right. Mm-hmm. So we go down to, this is one of the most latest draconian rules. Some companies in the US are going to be fined $700,000 if do not get their employees these things.
Yeah.
All right. They are putting pressure on the owners of huge companies.
Yes. And, yes.
Yeah.
I think it's 100 staff or plus. If any company with 100 staff or plus has to.
Oh yeah, that's right. That's right. But whistleblowers have come up to say now that about 50,000 Medicare patients, that's also in the U.S., have died. So more and more of these news are coming up.
Well, I can tell you another story too. we have a man that I met here recently, and he's aware of what's going on. And he said that the ambulances have been told to turn their sirens off because they're so busy and they're going constantly that if they had them on all the time, people would start really, realizing what's going on. So they've been actually asked to turn them off, and I see them going all the time, and often they have their sirens off. So be aware of that, and I'm sure if you're aware of what's going on in your surroundings around you, everyone's noticing more and more ambulances all the time.
Yeah, and I like this next headlines: crazy 4C move the goalposts again. Now you need 2 + 1 to be even considered as being fully, you know.
Exactly. And so, and don't they do that all the time? The goalposts. There's no set goalposts anywhere with the that agenda. You never know where you are, and you're always confused because you don't know what's going on. Yeah.
Yeah. And of course, the Israelis Israel is one of the countries that has the most people immunized, and they now realize that they may not want to have all this nonsense anymore. So there are a lot of protests and uprising in Israel where we do not get the news. All right. So here is just a little summary of what exactly been going on in the last 2 weeks or so.
Yes, fantastic.
Right? As a sort of to tell the world that these things are going on, and there are some good news, you know, as well. So, and it helps to cut short our discussions so that people can now look for this news and be aware.
Absolutely.
What's really happening?
That's right. And anyone out there that wants to put out the truth, you know, my hat goes off to you because you're needed at the moment.
Yeah.
That's right. So is there any final things that you'd like to share that you think are important at the moment?
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
I just remembered. I want to talk about the volcano in La Palma, Canary Island.
Okay.
Many times I've connected with the volcano to ask the volcano, is there going to be a huge eruption? All right. So I've got the answer three times. She told me that there's going to be a huge eruption, but I can't pinpoint the time. Right now, I'm going to do it live, and I'm going to ask the message from the volcano as the latest update. Can you give me a minute?
Beautiful. That would be wonderful. Thank you.
I'm getting the same answers, Medini, for the fourth time. And this is the latest today. The answer she gave me is that, yes, Mother Earth is waiting for people in the Canary Islands and the nearby islands actually to evacuate. There is going to be a bigger eruption coming up. And I asked for the timeline and I still get the same answer and I can't believe it within a month or so. And the last answer I got is I really do not like to say it, but we are people. I think this is not fear. This is more than to have a knowledge and to get ready, especially for the people of the Canary Islands. The worst volcanic eruption was Krakatoa.
Yes.
In Indonesia.
Yeah.
So I asked what kind of explosion La Palma will get in terms of the size of the Krakatoa explosion, which was the worst and very, very huge and affected the planet. The answer I got is, Medini, it's close to 8 in a Krakatoa scale.
Right. 8 out of 10, yeah.
Yeah, 8 out of 10, and 10 being Krakatoa. Mm. So I don't like to say this, but at the same time, if I have the ability to peep in the future, although the future is not set in stone, because Mother Earth can always intervene.
Yes.
All right. So, but I would advise the people of Canary Island to take note of their surroundings and to keep up with the latest news of their area and locality, and to think of long-term in the event of an evacuation that is to be to get more people out, all right? And then the other thing is there are huge underground tunnels in that island. And La Palma volcano is actually dealing with that.
Right. Also. I was going to ask you what do you think are the reasons behind this volcanic activity? So there is the benevolent forces trying to shift all the underground activity that has been used for the dark ones.
Yeah.
Also, is it a release that Mother Earth is having?
It's also a release of all the toxic energy that has been she has accumulated over the centuries.
Yes, that's what I was thinking. Yeah.
Because also, I saw in a Spanish documentary about the Canary Island. It's a hotbed of
trafficking.
Many cults, many cults.
Right.
All right. Yeah. And even in their local culture, in their celebrations, parts of this cult are being celebrated out in the open, but many people don't understand.
Mm. Yeah.
All right. They think it's a big celebration.
Yeah.
All right. So, but many of the celebrations and the portrayals have deep meanings of these cults.
Yes, sort of dark rituals. Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. So she's dealing with all that. And just hang on, I want to confirm one more message I just got. Mm-hmm. Okay. Surprisingly, I got a message that volcanoes in the Philippines will become active.
Right.
So we can conclude, therefore, that the Mother Earth is releasing a lot of pent-up toxic energy, and these activities with earthquakes is going to shift the plates, realign them.
Mm.
All right. So some islands may rise, some islands may fall, and then it was very surprising to me about the Philippine volcanoes going to be in active mode very soon.
Yes. It reminds me of a metaphor for a pimple. You know, when you've got toxins on your skin and you have a pimple and it sort of erupts and it comes out and it can clear it. I had that in my mind as you were talking.
Right. Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
Oh, so Madeni, before we end up this interview, I would like to give some blessings.
Oh, that's so exciting. I love that bit. That will be truly needed and appreciated at the moment is the word.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to concentrate on Melbourne. I'm going to concentrate on Sydney, as well as Newcastle. I have reasons. And then basically I'm going to do this work right now in silent mode. Madeni, anytime you can just hook onto my energy by calling my name, and together we will do it. Okay? So just take 3 breaths and I will begin.
Thank you.
Oh, wonderful. It's quicker than I thought, Madeni.
Beautiful, very strong energy, Hawk. I could, you know, really feel it.
Thank you very much. I saw a lot of dark energies being sucked up and siphoned to be processed and transmuted. So hang on. I also would like to send special energies to the original people of Australia.
Mm.
I will spend a few seconds with that. May I?
And yes, we love to acknowledge all the originals in Australia, all their ancestors, and acknowledge that, you know, their beautiful contribution to the planet as well. Our thoughts go out to them all, and we hope they're all fully protected at this time and supported. Thank you.
Oh, I have a little story before I go into these blessings. When my mother was alive, she was in Sydney, and she's in Sydney for very many years. She told me she saw an original Australian chief carried by four other original people walking past her. So it tells me a lot. My mother too was connected with Australia, and the spirits of the original people with the chief been carried by four other people showed themselves to my mom.
So in spirit, that was in spirit, yes.
Yes. Beautiful. But she saw it as clear as daylight.
Yes, yes.
All right. She told me this many times.
Mm.
Yeah. And I have a small replica of an Australian art.
Yes.
It's not with me here in this house. It's with me in the other house. So else I would have showed it. Very proud of that when I bought it from one of the original people.
Lovely.
I
think that's very profound, that sharing. And your connection with Australia as well. Thank you.
Yeah, indeed. So it's also in the memory of my mom. Mm. And here is my blessings for the original people of Australia.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, that's beautiful. Well, that's a perfect way, I think, to finish our conversation today. I hope to chat again with you soon. I think we covered some really, essential areas in our discussion today. I hope that people listening have got something helpful from it. And thank you, everyone, also who's watching. Please like, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed. And I'd like to give, really strong thank you to Hock for your wonderful presence today and your wisdoms and your blessing. You have a wonderful connection, and it's just a blessing in my life. So thank you, Hock. Thank you for everything you're doing, your universal service. And great to finish on that note. Thank you.
Thank you, Medini, and for your great work as well. Bless you.
Thank you.
And I finish off with all need all for. Bye.
Bye. Thank you.